know it sounds strange. He's with me here tonight, and I would like to introduce all of you to my spirit energy, Desmond. And best case scenario, you will actually see an orb, a ball of light near Heidi's shoulder.
Oh my God.
I need to clarify something important that many of the so-called skeptics fail to understand. Countless skeptics to the demon magician hypothesis made some ignorant assumptions based on the title of the series alone, so here I will set them straight. 1. The series is not saying that the magicians are demons, but that demons are operating from outside of the magician, manipulating objects in various ways. Rarely do the demons actually have to take control of the magician. 2. Not all magicians get help from demons, and many of them don't even know that demons can assist them in their profession. Only a select few. From my research, less than 50 demon magicians are active at any one time. 3. Not every single trick or performance they do is assisted by demons. They do this on purpose. They don't want 100% of their tricks to have no explanation. They need the atheists and so-called hardcore skeptics to have something to hold onto. Because they will see them do one natural trick, and they will instantly assume that all the others are or could be natural too. I used to think that exact way too, when I was an atheist 8 years ago. But now, knowing that some of their performances are assisted by demons, I know that all could be. It's easy to spot a demon magician. Usually they are extremely famous, and love to use Illuminati or satanic symbolism. Something that you will have noticed watching the previous episodes.
The eye in the hand. And what is that? What is the eye in the hand? Let's see that again.
Protection.
Protection. What does that mean?
Protection from death.
Oh.
Ask yourself why that is the case if all of these magicians have nothing in common. Hans Klock and Mike Super are two very famous magicians and both had the word demon hidden in their acts. They often hide the truth in plain sight. Demons just can't help to brand their human tools. In Mike Super's case, he might not even be aware that the spirit he is in contact with is a demon. As you heard him say, he believes it to be some sort of spirit energy or angel. I can tell you one thing, angels who are loyal to God will not perform magic tricks for entertainment while pretending to be something else. That's exactly what a demon would do. The Bible even says that Satan is the ruler of this planet and that demons will deceive even the very elect with their signs and wonders. In other words, deceive and confuse mankind with their supernatural powers. I know that this is extremely hard to believe for many people, so I will try to clarify it even more. Many struggle with the idea of demons partnering up with these entertainers. They can't imagine how this could happen. It is complicated to explain since not every case is identical. In most cases, it is generational. A certain bloodline may have originally made a pact with the demon even thousands of years ago, and passed on the secret to select members of their offspring. Obviously, demons helping certain humans is not limited to entertainment or magic, but to all human professions. If the Bible is correct, angels and demons predate the creation of this physical universe, so obviously their knowledge about all the elements and how to manipulate them are unmatched. Many scientists would love to get a piece of that knowledge. I found a video recently from a self-proclaimed black magician. He explains how he became a magician and how to make contracts with demons, and how demons can help you in your life and profession.
The demonic circle, a symbol of great power, used through most of my career as a black magician. And I have the symbols of the various pacts that I've made with demons throughout my workings, as I have walked my own path of embracing the darkness.
He teaches what type of rituals to do to call upon certain demons and what particular demon to summon for specific needs. You might have even seen one of his advertisements when watching videos on YouTube. He claims that demons are just here to help humans become living gods. I am not going to tell you the name of his channel, but I am going to show you a clip from one of his videos where he talks about his pact with a demon. Since this guy is a demon puppet himself, 99% of what you will hear him say on his channel is lies. Demons probably even tell him what to say in his videos. The only truthful part of all the things he says on his entire channel is that humans can indeed call upon demons and make contracts with them.
Now, Lucifer Drovacal is one of those shadowy figures in occult lore who intrigues and confuses at the same time. Lucifuge appears in the Grand Grimoire as not just a demon to make a pact with, but as the demon to call when you're going to make a pact. I've heard the name Lucifuge several times. Not once has he ever been spoken of lightly or happily, but always in whispers and followed by warnings. Do not work with this demon. He's too powerful, too evil, too hot for any magician to handle. Of course, such words of warning have always served to stimulate my interest even more. And so, I began to work with this demon.
That does not mean that anyone who tries to summon a demon or ask for a demon to contact him will receive it. There are countless persons out there who would love to take the easy route and ask for demonic assistance for their earthly needs. Demons, however, only contact people with certain attributes that they see valuable. If they cannot find a use for you, they will ignore you. They already employ hundreds of puppets throughout the world, so they can afford to be picky.
The oracle, as you put your hand on it, would just move around. Well, my brother's a jokester, you know, I thought he's doing it. He's trying to convince me he's not doing this. But what I did, I took the Ouija board by myself up to my bedroom one night.
But the Ouija board still answered his questions, and Jeff knew some other force was at work.
It scared me, but at the same time, it was kind of like a roller coaster ride. You're scared to death, but you're thrilled. I began to recognize after this that there was a presence that began to develop in my house. I mean, I would wake up in the middle of the night and literally feel someone's watching me. And I would wake up and literally walk through the house in order to experience that because I liked it.
Soon after his experience with the Ouija board, the presence Jeff felt in his home spoke to him.
I woke up one night and literally, there was like a voice behind my ear saying, Jeff, come, you know, come here, I got something to show you.
This strange force took Jeff on out-of-body experiences. During these times, he saw things days before he experienced them in real life. Then Jeff met a man who happened to be a practicing Satanist.
He prayed over me and laid hands on me. And when he laid hands on me, I was filled with a demon.
Jeff believed Satanism was the path to honing his paranormal abilities.
And when a demon is around you or is inside of you, the sensation or the sense of their presence, you lie to yourself. You think that that's your power level.
No matter what they tried, Jeff and the demonic forces inside him just couldn't kill that little seed of love and compassion. So the demons that had given him power for so many years turned on Jeff and tried to kill him instead.
The following magician is a famous Greek street magician, commonly referred to as the Mystifier.
You were thinking, what is it, right?
The word. Oh, I'm gonna try something else right now. With your mind again, okay? Something that really needs being concentrated. Let me try.
I have seen a lot of performers doing levitation. But I'll tell you this. When Neophidos does his levitation, it is so real that I ask myself, how did he do it? Does Neophidos really have powers to levitate? You will have to be the judge yourselves.
Espera, Dia. Espera, déjame de. Escala, es para ahí. Ωραία, εντάξει. Λοιπόν, θα δοκιμάσω κάτι μαζί σας. Και καταρχάς ήθελα να σας ρωτήσω, έχετε ακούσει ποτέ για αυτό που λέμε ότι όταν το σώμα, το μυαλό και το πνεύμα ενωθούν, μπορούμε να κάνουμε απίστευτα πράγματα. Θα συγκεντρωθώ, από τα τσιαλή δευτερόλεπτα, κάνουμε τελή ησυχία, οκ. Okay.
Πολλές φορές σιώ του Νεοφίδου, αλλά τούτο που είδα σήμερα μπροστά μου ήταν το απίθανο, ήταν εν ήξερα μπορώ να πω. Ήταν μες στον αέρα, μόνο στο ερωί του, έγινε.
Ήρθε ο Νεοφίδος, είπε μας να συγκεντρωθεί, να κάνει κάτι με το πνεύμα και το σώμα του και πραγματικά, δεν ξέρω, πέτασε, ερωί του, δεν έγιζε πάνω στη γη.
Είδα αρκετές φορές των νεοφυτών και αλήθεια ασχολήθηκα και εγώ με τέτοιου είδους πράγματα, αλλά τούτο που είδαμε σήμερα με τον νεοφυτό ήταν. Δεν μπορώ να το εξηγήσω. Ήταν κάτι εντελώς διαφορετικό, το οποίο μπορεί να είναι και ανεξήγητο, δεν ξέρω.
Ήταν κάτι πολύ δυνατό. Δεν ξέρω τίποτε παρόμοιο.
Πρώτη φορά χωρίς πράγμα γίνεται. Εωρίτουν μες στον άρα. Εωρίτουν ήταν.
He put his hands down and he just. His legs went off the ground and he started flying. It was unbelievable. It was really, really crazy.
It was about like 40 centimeters off the ground, literally. Like he was really in the air, like that much off the ground. And it was unbelievable. Like we really couldn't believe it because 40 centimeters is a lot for levitating in the air. Just like, oh my gosh.
It's all over.
I'll end this episode with footage from a famous show that is called Fool Us, by Penn Teller. Penn Teller are demon magicians themselves. They are good friends of Chris Angel, and they made a show where they pretend to judge other magicians. 99% of what the contestants do are performances that Penn Teller never performed, but they still claim to know how they are done. What you are about to see is a demon spirit moving objects for Teller.
The next trick is done with just a piece of thread.
Sublime artistry of Penn Teller, ladies and gentlemen.
Here is just one clip I'll show you from What Demons Are Doing to Humanity. It will be a series similar to this, but focused specifically on the pain and suffering caused to the human race by demons.
I use cut from his throat down to his stomach, and I ate him. Bits of him.
They killed a man at a ceremony?
Yeah.
In front of you?
Yeah, in front of all of them.
What did they say about the devil, about Lucifer?
that killing the people made him happy.
Sacrifices to please the devil. According to Teresa, the worst rituals took place at a house somewhere in the country.